Us, but prior to that, there was like this viral article that you sold your house and you sold it for bitcoins.
Yeah.
Is it true? Tell us more.
Yeah, it's true. It's true.
Okay, so was it entire house and cars and everything what you had?
Yeah, it was everything and it still is everything. So our cars, our house, my companies, my kids' toys, my pension fund.
And when was it? And how much was Bitcoin back then?
When I was in Bali, I sold my Jeep Cherokee and my car and my mm-hmm. cabriolet, and then Bitcoin was around 1,200. So that mm-hmm, went mm-hmm. in at 1,200. And the last part was invested was my pension fund at $3,800. Yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And did you?
No. If Bitcoin will crash, that is my escape plan. Then I will sell her, rent her out, whatever. And I have still three beautiful daughters. I can also no. I will never monetize my wife or children.
And why did you put everything into Bitcoin?
Because I believe in Bitcoin.
So you're Bitcoin maximalist, so to say, or do you have
so to say,
I'm cryptocurrencies?
I'm a Bitcoin maximalist, but mm-hmm. I love all cryptos, and I think that it's time that people need to understand that they need to stop throwing mud at each other and Bitcoin Cash and Bitcoin and all those nonsense. This is like immature market growth, and this is not okay for the Bitcoin and for crypto and for blockchain. We need to understand if we want to win this revolution, if we want to disrupt the monetary system, we need to work together. You know, it's one mm-hmm. big fight and we need to do it together and not separate teams. Every coin has a different speciality mm-hmm. and every member of the community has a different speciality, but they need to understand they cannot win this revolution alone. They need each mm-hmm. other. Messi cannot win any match if he doesn't have any players with Barcelona. This is the same for crypto and blockchain. We need to work together to disrupt the system.
You mentioned monetary systems, so do you think Euro will survive next 20 years? Or
no, not at all. Euro will be dead, dollar will be dead, all cash will be dead, I think. And in my opinion, everything is going to be digital. I don't know if you will have one worldwide coin. Maybe we'll have a few digital coins, but...
Mm. But you know there are efforts from ECB and other entities for creating cryptocurrency, like crypto euro or crypto dollar or whatever. So maybe they might be the next digital asset, which we'll be using.
Yeah, that's all possible. In my opinion, Bitcoin is still the only real decentralized one, you know? There is no spokesman, there is no ego behind that wants to shout, I'm the best, I'm the biggest. It's just Bitcoin. This mm-hmm. one is decentralized. This one is not presented by a spokesman or a foundation in the way that they want to be important.
Mm-hmm.
They want to just change the world. They want to live by Satoshi's vision.
And how long have you been in crypto space, by the way?
I started mining in 2012, end 2012, mm-hmm. beginning 2013, and then mm-hmm. I had a crash in 2014. Then I stepped over mining to Dogecoin, so I have still a few million Dogecoins. I still have them. They are going to be huge.
Yeah.
In the Chinese year of the dog, they will be a dollar, I think. That's, at least that was what I hoped. But yeah, I've been around some time. I had some crashes. Mm-hmm. I don't see them as crashes, I see them as evolution mm-hmm. of technology growth.
And why did you make the decision to sell all your property back then on that specific time frame?
Because I wasn't happy with my life. I wanted mm-hmm. to change life. I didn't want to be the materialistic guy anymore with all those mm-hmm. cars and houses. And mm-hmm. I just wanted to be a very simple guy, and I wanted to show my kids that they can be very healthy and lucky and happy with not all the money. You can mm-hmm. be happy without money. And I think that is what crypto is about. It's not just about Lamborghinis and all those things. It's about people are feeling they need to change. You know, people want to change. People want to see more of the world. You don't want a job 40 hours in a week, same office every morning, same routine, running the rat race.
And what do you think of ETFs stepping into Bitcoin ecosystem? Do you see them as a threat?
No, I see them as money. So yeah, they will make sure money will get in the market,
mm-hmm.
but I see them as a threat. And if you look at the decentral part of it, because if big organizations are investing all money, for example, in Bitcoin or in Bitcoin Cash, so what will happen when this currency will be forked?
Mm-hmm.
Will this company receive those forked coins? Will the people? So, and if you are in it for freedom and mm-hmm. decentralization, then the ETF is not really a good step, I think.
Mm-hmm.
we've come so far without them, and I think we can go further without them as well.
Mm-hmm. So we are not that kind of person who would have the private keys geographically distributed. I know some people who split the private key into few parts and they spread them across Europe, for instance.
Yeah, you can do this, and of course you could do it with your wife, and you can do it with your. You can spread mm-hmm. them as much as you want. You can easily step back to your PayPal wallet. You can even make a PayPal wallet in how is the company called? They make it on iron. You know, they press a code in iron.
Mm-hmm.
So there are many options, but CryptoTech, yeah. And one side, I'm a hodler, mm-hmm. but on the other side, I think we need to spend as well. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we need to support this crypto scene.
Mm-hmm.
And by spending, you support the miners, yeah. And you can build more and more and more.
And are you actively looking for merchants who are accepting cryptocurrency or not? Or are you more cashing out and spending euros? Or are you looking for merchants who accept crypto?
I prefer merchants that accept crypto. So mm-hmm. if I have to travel 10 minutes or 20 minutes, I will go there. And
okay.
I just traveled the whole Europe for 6 months. And I found that like a lot of countries are accepting crypto even more than the Netherlands. I think in mm-hmm. the Netherlands we are way behind many countries I visited.
So in which country would you like be having no problem to spend crypto?
It's different. Every country has its, for example, in Spain. I just mm-hmm. was in Spain, and you can buy cryptocurrencies. You can buy bitcoins at every grocery store. You know, you have the Carrefour.
Really?
There are more than mm-hmm. 10,000 Carrefours in Spain. I can walk in, do my groceries, and buy bitcoins at the same cashier. In Switzerland, I go to the train station, and there's this fancy machine where you can buy your train tickets.
Mm-hmm.
But in Switzerland, you can buy bitcoins in the same machine.
Mm-hmm. And so what is your opinion why there is such a significant difference between the Netherlands and Spain?
My eye-opener was Rovereto, Italy. This is a small village, historical village, small, really cool town. 60 shops in this town accept Bitcoin directly. So there was a butcher, for example, and I walked in this butcher, and you see all those meat things hanging and those self-made jam and all those things, and very beautiful store. And this woman was working there, and she was like 60 plus. And she was like, we accept Bitcoin. I said, okay. She said, do you know how to accept Bitcoin? And I bought something, and she knew how to accept Bitcoin.
Mm-hmm.
So 60 stores in this small town, historical town, were able to accept Bitcoin and convert it if they want or not.
Mm-hmm.
So this was, for me, was like, okay, if this small historical classical town in Italy can do it, then mm-hmm. every town can do it. But every town needs a motor, needs one mm-hmm. company that provides them of the platform of accepting crypto and even eventually exchanging mm-hmm. it to fiat if they want.
And the last question, what do you think how regulation will shape the cryptocurrency space for in the future? Will it support it, or will it be a bottleneck for this innovation?
I'm in it for the freedom. So for me, I hate regulations. I understand that the regulations need to be there for ICOs. I understand that a lot of people are losing money, not only winning. We won, but a lot of people lose every day. Last night, some people lost as well. But I don't think regulations have to be there to regulate the financial market. They need to regulate the newcomers into this financial market, the ICOs and the new coins. But coins like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and for example, Litecoin, where so many billion dollars is circulating, what do you want to regulate? They came this far without regulations. We don't need the regulations.
Mm-hmm.
We need a certain digital cash. So you can hand me your 5 euro bill now, and nobody can interfere us. But if all those bills will disappear in the future, how do you want to give me something without interference of a third party? This is why I believe in Bitcoin, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So then I don't need this regulation. I want to be able to spend my money where I want, when I want, how I want. This mm-hmm. is why we need to be in crypto. And this is why regulations shouldn't be in the top notch, but in the bottom, where mm-hmm. new scams are created every day.
Okay. And last thing, I heard you wrote a book, right?
Yeah,
can you tell us more?
Yeah, we wrote a book in Dutch. It's for sale now. You can buy it on our website, but also at bol.com. But buy it on my website. I earn a little bit more money on that. And we share our profit with everything we do. We share it with poor people, crypto education. Everywhere we travel, we spend money and foundations, charities, and all those things, because we don't need a Lamborghini or a villa. We just need a tent. And so this book is now being translated in English and German. And it's a book about my life. How did a guy grow up to become this big of idiot to go all in with everything he had? What did it take this to create a mindset? How do you live day by day now with this mindset? You know, Bitcoin is going up and going down and people are, it's crashing. So how do you, how do you live with this? How do you, how can you prepare for this if you do the same? And the book is full with tips and advice in crypto and all those things, and many things about crypto, but also about a story of a family trying to change the world. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Marius.
Can I ask one question?
Yeah, you can buy it with crypto, yeah. To be honest, it was in Bali. It really happened like this. It was in Bali, and my kids were playing on the beach, and I was drinking my favorite drink. I always drink Bacardi Coke. So I was drinking, and I was enjoying the sunset. My kids were playing, and a friend called me, and he was, Didi, check your coins, man. And I said, like, I don't want to check my coins. I'm enjoying the sunset, Bacardi Coke. I was a little bit wasted, of course, on the beach. And and then he was very persuading, please check them. And then in the evening, I checked them, and I was like, okay, I can pay all my trip I've made the last 9 months. It's going up and up and up. So I looked at my wife, and I told her, do you still know the Bitcoin thing I was doing then the days with mining? And those computers. Yeah, I said, those computers, you know. I want to go all in. And she was like, all in what? He said, all in this Bitcoin. And what do you mean? He said, yeah, sell our house, our cars, our clothes, our toys, everything, our bank account. And she was like, but what? I said, yeah, just all in. And I said, but, and then she told me, prove it. Didi, you're the most materialistic bastard I'd ever met, man. You want to be on the top of the world with your bottles of Belvedere and all the shit and your motorcycles and your Jeep Cherokee. You want to go all in? You want to walk barefooted with just shorts, no Armani shirts anymore and all that shit? And I said, yeah. And then she told me, prove it. And then when she was sitting there in the restaurant, I put my car for sale on Market Space here in Holland. And the second one as well, my motorcycle as well, it was sold. I bought Bitcoins, and then she was like, yeah, okay, let's go all in. And then the day after we woke, she was like, maybe we need to rethink about it. And then I used my secret card, and this one is special for women. And I told them, but we need to show our kids that they can be happy without money. And then it was easy. Then it was yes. Yes, we have did a wrong job in educating our kids. We are going to educate them in the right way now. And then, she sold all her shoes, her clothes, and all her things. And yeah, and now I'm walking with the cheap shirts I give. They give it to me so for free.